rebellion. Revelio. Rebellion.
This could prove dangerous if I'm not careful. Wonder who lives here?
Off on another adventure, are we?
Most excellent.
Nice to see you, my young friend.
Not sure how I'd fare in a little...
Bard of Beaumont should have returned by now. Had by dark wizards he was.
Excuse me, did you say something about a Bard of Beaumont?
I did. I don't think we've met. I'm Dorothy Sprottle. I was just worrying about Claire Beaumont's brother, Bardolph. Only he's gone missing. Rumour is he was seen in the forest practising dark magic. Saw him myself near some ruins with Rookwood's lot I did. I fear he got himself into trouble with the Ashwinders, especially if he made them a promise he couldn't keep. I'd help search for him myself, but no one will risk encountering Ranrock's loyalists. They seem to be everywhere.
Why would Bardolph want to get involved with the Ashwinders?
Oh, he had a terrible run-in with Ranrock's loyalists. Changed him. He vowed never to feel powerless again. I think he sought the Ashwinders out to learn their secrets. Victor Rookwood, at least, seems somehow immune to Ranrock's loyalists.
Do you think Bardolph may have simply run off?
No. Bardolph's run that shop with Claire his entire life. He'd not give it up for anything. He swore he'd be back in a fortnight. My instincts are that he's been held captive, or worse.
I can certainly look out for him.
Any help would be appreciated. You might speak to Claire first. Perhaps she has some insights that I don't. I can tell you that Bardolph was last seen in the forest wearing a particular woolen jumper, one that Claire knitted herself. Claire will be at her shop if you'd like to speak with her.
Revelio.
Intriguing.
Revelio.
Seems a pleasant enough little place.
I could use some gold. Come now, don't be stingy. Dips in the hat, if you please. New instruments are expensive, you know.
Revelio. Revelio. Revelio.
Wonder who lives here.
I remember you. Your generosity helped me afford this rather
Revelio. Revelio.
Huh. Not sure how I'd fare in a little place like this.
Revelio.
Brown Rock's loyalists are a menace. What can be done?
Madame Beaumont, might I speak with you?
Yes. What about?
Mrs. Sprottle told me a little about your brother's disappearance.
Oh, dear Dorothy. She'd go looking for Bardolph herself if she could.
She mentioned dark magic, and even the Ashwinders.
Despite my repeated warnings, Bardolph's been experimenting with dark magic near the edge of the forest. I thought perhaps he'd get it out of his system and it would gradually stop. But then one day, he didn't come home.
Could Bardolph have run off?
No. He'd never leave me here alone. He did speak of going to talk with Victor Rookwood. That worries me almost more than his attempts at mastering dark magic. Rookwood is as dangerous as Ranrok, in my opinion.
Is there anything your brother took with him that might help to track him down?
Only his satchel, journal, and a woolen jumper I knitted for him. That's all I can recall.
I'll let you know if I see or hear anything about him.
Thank you. How kind. I'd be so grateful to learn where he is. I know in my heart he's out there. Do be careful.
I should be going now. Thank you. Upper Hogsfield is being terrorized by Ranrok's loyalists. It's not... I couldn't help it over here. Did you mention Ranrok's loyalists?
I did. Never imagined they'd act this deadly. I'm Claire Beaumont, by the way.
Nice to meet you.
Ranrok and his followers have set up camp here. No regard for our beloved hamlet or our livelihoods. Ruthless. My brother Bardolph dared to stand up to them and ended up in St. Mungo's. Simply at my wit's end.
How did your brother Bardolph end up in St. Mungo's?
Bardolph had spent the entire day handpicking herbs and roots for us. When a group of Ranrok's lot appeared and demanded the harvest for themselves, Bardolph refused. In their anger, they hurled him against a rock and robbed him. The moment he left St. Mungo's, he vowed revenge. I worry he may be dabbling in magic that he will one day regret.
You said Ranrok's loyalists have set up camp here. Where precisely?
To the south, across the river. Last I heard, there were several loyalists in each camp. I won't go near them.
Why don't you simply leave the area for now?
Upper Hogsfield is my home. Bardolph and I grew up here. No, we are standing firm. Once my brother returns, then we shall decide what to do next. He's gone to seek Victor Rookwood's advice. I didn't approve of that idea, but perhaps in the end it will help.
I am unfortunately quite familiar with Ranrok's loyalists. Perhaps I can do something.
Much as I would love to be rid of them, I wouldn't want you to risk injury or worse. Please be cautious. We should not have to live in fear. This is our home.
Revelio.
It seems as though things are getting worse. Best be on my guard.
Revelio.
Well, I wouldn't give for a...
One of Ranrock's camps. Exactly as Madame Beaumont described. Yes!
Revelio.
do you have in store for me this time? Revelio. 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 Revelio.
You can't imagine how inconvenient travel was before I invented flu powder.
I would so appreciate a little help.
What seems to be the problem?
You may well ask. I'm convinced I saw a Grimm, an omen of death. I'm not safe, but if it can't see me, I'll be all right, won't I? All I need is an invisibility potion. Yes, that's what I need.
I'm afraid I'm all out of invisibility potion. I suggest finding somewhere safe and being especially careful.
Safe? Careful? Yes, that makes sense. And you're sure you don't... No. Very well. Hopefully the Grimm, or whatever it has foretold, doesn't get me first.
Revelio.
Hello. Do you have anything for sale?
That I do. But what's a student like yourself doing out here? Got yourself lost, did you?
Just exploring the countryside a bit.
Aye. Nice to break the routine now and then. Bit of a wanderer myself, in fact. My name's Leopold Babcock, and I am indeed here to sell. Now, for someone like yourself who is also prone to wander, I cannot understate the importance of keeping some Wiggenweld potion on hand. I wouldn't dare set foot in a place like the Forbidden Forest without a steady supply. What do you say, my young friend? A measure of safety for the path ahead?
Something to consider. Thank you for your help, Mr. Babcock.
Aye, let me know if you see something you like.
What do you have for sale?
See if there's something you need. I shall hope to do business with you again. Thank you for your patronage. That's been a pleasure.
These rocks have seen better days. Revelio. 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 Revelio.
Pitiful display.
Beaumont will be glad to hear that. Confringo! Revelio! This place has seen better days. Revelio.
Thank you.
Seems a pleasant enough little place.
Revelio.
Oh, I do miss the bustle of business.
If day goes by, I don't know something I didn't
forbid to venture out.
Hello, Madame Beaumont. Good news. I was able to clear out Ranrock's camps.
You cleared them out? How?
I managed to catch them off guard.
When my brother returns, this news will mean the world to him. You saved our hamlet, my young friend. This will not be forgotten. I fear for other hamlets, truly. Ranrock and his lot are unlike any goblins I've ever seen.
What do you have for sale?
What are you looking for exactly? Thank you. Sincerely. Marvellous. I could always use more of these. Thank you for passing through.
Spare a canoe, a sickle, a galleon.
Revelio.
Who needs keys when you know Alohomora?
Oh, no, don't be stingy.
Revelio.
Thank you.